Hello, you Malte Mendelssohn matrimonial marches. Yep, I got that right. And thank you to Alec Kay for that malt mention. Thank you, Alec, for your malt mention. This is the Manx Bothy. This is Ralfy Review, scoring out the malt mentions so they don't get repeated accidentally in my little blue malt mention book. There you go. You see, and I write it down so as it doesn't... So it's all listed. These are more malt mentions. I've got pages of malt mentions. So if you've malt mentioned, please be patient. I'll get round to you at some point. Right. This is an extras in which, having reviewed a single malt Scotch whisky or some other quality spirit from around the world in the official review, the Ralfy Review, I go on to discuss another topic, another subject, another element of whisky which may be of interest to whisky fans and spirit fans all around the world. And I would like to introduce you to a bottle of wine. Right. Now, there's a story behind this. Are you sitting comfortably? Okay. Nice single malt this, but hard to get to know. Needs time. It's quite sappy, quite resinous, because of additional cask maturation. This was it, the Glenallachie, or Glenallachie, as I pronounce it, and there's nothing wrong with that. Every distillery has several pronunciations, no matter what the experts tell you. There is no one single pronunciation. The bottom line is, as the customer, if you've bought the bottle and paid for the bottle and it's your bottle and you're enjoying it, you can call it whatever you damn well want. And do not feel the need to be censored by the malt police. Because some of the self-appointed malt police take things far too seriously. Just sharing. This is a bottle of wine in a whisky review. I'm halfway through it. And I opened this bottle of wine yesterday to celebrate the fact that I was at the end of a 20-week nutritional control program as part of a weight cut in which I lost quite a lot of weight. It probably shows in my face. In my next extras, I'm going to tell you more about it. So stay tuned. It's been a very interesting experience and it has affected my sense of smell and taste. In particular, my sense of taste. And I want to talk about that because there's things about it I feel it could work for, that could work for you. But anyway, as a reward at the end of this significant weight loss, I wanted to reward myself without going overboard and without piling on too many calories too soon. So I had a small portion of fish and chips from the local fish and chip shop, which was absolutely delicious. So essentially I got a good protein hit from the fish and a good carb up and a little bit of fat, not too much, but a good carb up from the potato chips, potato fries, you might be calling them. And to finish it off, I had a total chill out where I just listened to dance music on YouTube, watched a few videos and chilled out to 1 o'clock in the morning, and I drank half a bottle of red wine with a drop of water in it just to open up and help oxidize it. Very nice Spanish Rioja, 2014 vintage. I like wines that are smooth but a little bit of roughness to them. I like a good strong tannin note but not oppressively so. And I find that I tend to go for Italian and Spanish wines at the moment because they, malt mates, are what float my wine boat. Simple as that. Now, thirdly, of course, I gave it a few hours to oxidise, very important, but I wasn't going to finish the bottle. So I've scooshed in using my private preserve gas preserver, some inert nitrogen, argon and carbon dioxide, so as to stop the wine oxidizing any further. So I shall finish this bottle tonight because I don't want it going to waste. But do you know, in a bottle of wine, there's a lot of calories. Alcohol contains almost as many calories per gram as fat does. Certainly, alcohol contains significantly more calories per gram Then protein and carbohydrates, which together are each 4 calories per gram. Fat is 9 calories per gram. Alcohol is 7 calories per gram. And also with alcohol, in its raw sense, it doesn't contain protein, fat or carbohydrates, so they are what's called by nutritionalists empty calories. So you have to factor these things into your nutritional program. But I'm having a bit of celebration, take my hair down, let my hair down a little bit, well, you know, what's left of it. And so I've got this bottle and I've been on eBay and I bought a little device which is for wine bottles. But do you know what? I think it would work so well for whiskey bottles. And I'm now going to take this opportunity, malt mates, to introduce it to you. It is the Wine Stopper Combination Lock. What a brilliant idea. There's a little button and you press it, blung, and the stopper, the security stopper, springs open. So there it is. There's the combination, 3-number combination, 3-digit combination with a little push button, and I've got it at 000 at the moment, so in case I forget what the number is, I can still open the bottle, smart thinking. And then I'm going to press a little silver button and you will watch it open. When I close it and change the combination, it locks shut. Right. I shall demonstrate. Over the bottle, lock it shut, change the combination. The only way someone can get into that bottle now is to smash the combination lock stopper or break the bottle itself. Or if they're being very crafty, drill a hole using a glass drill in the bottom of the bottle, drain out the contents and replace them with black currant juice. You never know, it might not get noticed. So, here we are. Would this work for whiskey? Of course it would. You and I, because we're malt mates, we know about these things. In our whiskey reception embassy, yes, you and I, we don't have whiskey corners anymore or whiskey rooms. We have personal private embassies. If it's good enough for McCann and Ardbeg, it's good enough for us. So we have our private hospitality embassies of malt stashes neatly laid out on the table, but there's always one or two which are particularly precious, and we may share a drop with very good maltsters who have good discerning palates, but we really wouldn't waste them on people of average experience. I know it's a little bit snobby, but hey, malt mates, it's real life. I'm just being pragmatic and practical here. That's all. So what an ideal solution. Now, this, by the way, will not work on a whiskey bottle. Goodness knows, I've tried it. Whiskey bottles, unfortunately, are not as similar as wine bottles in consistency of shape. So it would really need, and this is an idea for distilleries, they could bespoke combination whiskey seal for their own bottlings. Look at that, me giving free marketing. How much would this cost you from the consultants, distillers? You know, listen up. This is good shit in this channel, by the way. This is an initiative, a serious initiative, and you're not having to pay £50,000 commission to the consultants. Yeah, £50,000. That's not unusual. Don't get me started. So here we are. This is on eBay, doesn't cost much. So you can get a combination lock, and what you'd do is you'd file out the inside of it. Bit of homework. And you'd make it fit your precious bottles, you see. Rightio. And even if you file out too much and it doesn't work, it's still good for a laugh. Even though it's no longer securing your bottles. Also, on a more serious note, if you've got inquisitive children, young children in your family, who are wanting to plunder your liquor cabinet, this is actually, apart from locking your cabinet, if you can't do that, or they're getting too smart, or they're getting unpicking the locks, you know what kids are like, you can actually use one or two of them on your bottles to act as a secondary deterrent. I think it's a great idea. I commend this. I recommend this. And I'm going to finish the rest of this bottle of red wine tonight. And then I will... It's been 6 months since I last had a bottle of wine. I'm going to have this bottle of wine and it'll probably be 6 months before I have my next. Because the great thing about when you're training and gaining at the gym and you're getting lean and strong and you're a nutritionally controlled diet, plain spirits with a drop of water is by far the most manageable, easy alcoholic control intake as part of a calorie controlled diet and a nutritional program. It has far less calories per experience than red wine or beers, particularly strong beers. Whiskey, gin, bourbon, vodka are just ideal. Small portions, keep it quality, not quantity. Do you know what? You cannot go wrong. I'm Ralfy. I'm all finished here. If you want to pop back again in a few days' time for my next Ralfy review, 744, I will be reviewing either an age-stated blend, which is really nice, or a version of Kalila, which is really, really nice. Whichever way, you're going to get a really nice or a really, really nice whiskey review, and you wouldn't want to miss it, would you? I'm Ralfy, waving bye-bye. Bye-bye.